In this video, we're given a simple harmonic oscillator with a mass of 600 grams and a spring constant of 8.5 newtons per meter. And we're told this is oscillating with an amplitude of 11 centimeters. In part A of the question, we're asked to compute the maximum speed of the oscillator, and this is a conservation of energy question. So the potential energy stored in the spring is 1/2 kx squared, where x is the displacement from the equilibrium position. And when x is equal to a, in other words, when I'm at this turning point at the maximum displacement from equilibrium, all the energy is spring potential energy because the mass is turning around. It's momentarily stationary. There's no kinetic energy. So I can say the total energy in this oscillator is equal to 1/2 ka squared. And then by the time the mass is passing through equilibrium, all the spring potential energy is gone because the spring is at its equilibrium length. So all the energy must be kinetic at this point. So that total energy is kinetic when I pass through the equilibrium position, and that corresponds to Vmax. So then I can quickly solve for Vmax. I multiply by 2, divide by m, and square root both sides, and I get that Vmax is square root k over m times a squared. It might be nice if we factor out the a squared and write it as square root of k over m multiplied by a. Now we can plug in the numbers, making sure to do all the necessary unit conversions. And k was 8.5 newtons per meter. M was 600 grams, that's 0.6 kilograms, and the amplitude was 11 centimeters, which is 0.11 meters. Again, that amplitude is outside of the square root now. Into three significant digits, I get 0.414 meters per second. In part B, we're asked to compute the frequency of oscillation, and I remember this formula that the period is 2 pi times the square root of m over k. And I'll post a link real quick to the video where this was first derived. Now, frequency is just the reciprocal of period, so that would be 1 over 2 pi square root of k over m. And all I have to do is plug in. Again, the mass has to be converted to kilograms, so I have 1 over 2 pi square root 8.5 over 0.6. Into three significant digits, I get 0.599, and the units of frequency are hertz. So a hertz is an oscillation per second, and that means this thing is oscillating less than once per second. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.